Chef Viola Buitoni is here.
Italian pasta royalty in studio with us this morning. Viola Buitoni.
Chef Viola Buitoni was born in Italy, however, has found a way to bring her Italian culture and flavor right here to not only America, but North Carolina.
A new book, Italy by Ingredient, is packed with flavor and the author's family heritage. Food writer Viola Buitoni.
That love of cooking is just passed down.
Completely, yes.
Is that what's in the love of this cookbook, Italy by Ingredient? Are there traditional recipes?
I would say they're more my modern sensibility, my take on the way that an Italian living in the States cooks with all the beautiful products coming in from Italy and the great agricultural bounty of
So I got my start because I got a summer job in a restaurant after school. I studied in New York because I came to the States when I was 19. So I studied in New York, then I finished and I didn't know what to do, and I decided that a restaurant for the summer could be a good place to be. What inspired me is my long work with Italian food, both as a family and also personally here in the States. In the last 12, 13 years, I've actually been teaching in San Francisco.
Oh, wow.
And so all the teaching with time, ingredient-driven teaching, the mix of the beautiful agriculture in San Francisco with Italian ingredients, inspired me to eventually put this together.
We're talking in the break about rice. When people think of Italian cooking, they only think one thing when it comes to rice.
Risotto.
Risotto.
So much more to rice. And I've actually been working in my book to expand the conception that people have of certain ingredients in Italian cooking, including rice.
You said you have a whole chapter on rice in this book.
I have a whole chapter, and I'm featuring, in addition to the ones that we all know, so Carnaroli and Arborio, there's a wonderful black rice called Artemide, which we will try today. As well as red rice and different types of white rice. Rice in Italy is used for soups, for salads, for sweets, for like many, many different things.
You told me before that you want to change the way people think about cooking Italian food.
Yes, when I tell people I have a book, the first thing they ask me is, what about pasta? And there are lots of pasta recipes in the book, but pasta is not one of the ingredients that I actually examine in depth. And also, there is no fresh pasta because this is a book for people who cook every day.
Okay.
And they live life the way that we do.
I love that. I love cooking.
How many recipes are in the new cookbook?
Between 75 and 80, I would say. Very modern sensibility to the recipes.
Well, and Viola.
Lots of Parmigiano is the last one.
Okay, beautiful. I know this is going to be delicious.
I'm going to put a little bit of salt and pepper.
Is something like this similar to... It seems like probably something we're not as familiar with, but like quinoa or rice, is it something you could add in instead of using those things?
You could. I would say more like a wheat berry.
Okay.
Like if you were to make a wheat berry salad, that would be a good one. It's got quite a different mouthfeel from quinoa and rice, but I think it would be a good substitute for a wheat berry.
It looks lighter.
It looks almost like oatmeal, but...
Yeah.
Yes. More poppy, like
yes, a little.
Kernel-y.
It's a little pop for sure. So I've seasoned it with salt, pepper, and some dried oregano. I'm going to put half my basil in here, and then I have some olives and capers mixed in here that are going in. After that, I will put in my fresh tomatoes.
And these are the just raw ones?
They are just raw ones, and they are quartered. For this recipe, I quarter them, and for the other recipe, I actually. Have them.
Gotcha. I love all the colors.
Mm-hmm. Thank you. I always get multicolor tomatoes because you know you eat with your eyes first, right?
When you're cooking something, it is important that you have different textures with each bite, correct?
Yes, I think it is. It makes the food more interesting. Mm-hmm. It engages the mouth. It wants you to make you want to try more. I love to put nuts in salad, for example.
Yes.
And if nuts are not a thing, you can do like some crunchy chickpeas, for example.
Oh, okay. Like roast your chickpeas?
Yeah, roasted chickpeas. Or sometimes you find them crunchy, like they are actually...
Already made.
Yeah, they're already made. You can use... pumpkin seeds, you can use sunflower seeds.
Perfect.
Yeah, something that is a little bit of crunch.
I always tell people to listen to their food, to look at their food, to just kind of make sure that it feels and looks and just sounds the way that it's supposed to. And that is going to be a much more precise gauge than time, for example. So every recipe in my book has a time range. And I always try to tell people what they should be listening for and what they should be smelling for and how their body should feel in relationship to the thing that they're cooking and eating.
I love it. Viola, thank you so much for being here.
And that is like art in your mouth on a plate. Thank you so much, Viola. This has been a pleasure cooking with you. Thank you for teaching us so much.
Thank you. Mm.
This is so fresh. Amazing. I can tell all the love and passion that you've put into this. Oh my gosh, that's fresh. Also, before you leave, you're going to have to show me how to cut this basil again. Have a great day.
Check out the book.
Thank you.